There we go. Got it. Thank you very much. All right, so I have lots of slides. I have to talk really fast. I apologize. But first, I want to say just thank you for having me here. What beautiful facilities. Thank you so much for allowing us to be here. So the NSF SBIR and STTR programs start off with phase one at $225,000. Ask for anywhere from 6 to 12 months. It's the only way to be able to apply for the phase two, which of course is the more significant amount of money, so $150,000 for a two-year research program. We have two funding cycles each year. You just missed one. Of course, you have to write a proposal to be able to be eligible to be reviewed. We will have another submission deadline in December. We don't have the exact date yet. The solicitation will be released in September, and it will have the exact date, but it should be in early December. Remember that when you submit a proposal to us, it does not constitute a public disclosure. All your information is treated as confidential, and you may mark proprietary information. It takes us about 3 to 5 months to review your proposal. I'm sorry it takes so long. We can't figure out quite another process that allows us to do it faster, but we are constantly discussing that and may find a solution. And usually you'll have your funding within 6 to 7 months. Let me talk briefly about our agency focus. We probably fund earlier than any other federal agency. We think of ourselves as providing pre-seed funding for you to commercialize your technology or to get that initial research done towards commercialization. We're the first money in. We have about $200 million at NSF to give to you every year. We fund about 400 plus companies now, and we are only a granting agency. Grants, not contracts. And of course, that's an equity of free investment. The aim of our program is to really provide funding to startups and small businesses developing high impact engineering and science-based products and services. I really think about this as being a way to de-risk your technology, and actually we provide some training, entrepreneurial training to you as well, so you're de-risking your business model to make you more attractive to private investment. That's our real goal. We want to see you contribute to the economy by growing your business and growing revenues and job growth in the future. What we fund novel, disruptive, game-changing technologies. I always call that NSF speak. It could be a product, process, or service. I'd like to see them be high impact, high risk, high payback. And what do I mean by high payback? That means you have to, and high impact is really that you are addressing a large market opportunity with a novel core technology development. Could be an enabling technology, could also be something that has a broad societal impact. What we don't fund, well, even though we're the NSF, we don't fund basic research in the SBIR and STTR programs. I know that doesn't seem probably to make sense, but that's the truth. And we also don't fund what we call incremental technology development. That is, if it's already been developed, it's a new application, it's already been commercialized, these are things we don't fund. So we really are looking for that novel new technology. And we have to fund just research based projects. So if you have an objective that's a business development objective, even though we emphasize business, it can't be something that we can fund with the research dollars we're providing to you. All right, we have lots of technology areas. Basically, we are extremely broad. We cover all areas of engineering and science and related educational topics as well. So really, I guess what I want to do is to say to you, if you go out to our website, you'll see very detailed descriptions under each of these headings. Ignore them, if you would please, because they're really meant to be just suggestions to you. We really want you to come with us with that unique idea, whether you see it in our description or not. And we're most likely going to tell you to submit a proposal. So do not use those as a way to gate your desire to submit to us. All right, how do you talk to us? Well, you know, you can talk to us anytime. You could, the best way to communicate is actually by email. We are really busy. And we would like you to send us an email with an attached executive summary that describes your business opportunity as well as your core technology and a little bit about the project that you would love, that we would fund. We also have now a portal on our website where you can submit the same executive summary. So you could use either method to get that information to us. We'll respond with comments. We'll talk a little bit. Usually, as people submitting, they're often the technical person, the engineer or scientist, and so we'll tell you a little bit about what we want to see in that commercial plan as well. So, but please feel free to contact us. It's not something you have to do, but I think you'll enjoy getting the feedback from us. I also wanted to say too, many of you have been in these sorts of sessions and hear people say, this is my first time submitting an SBIR. I've never submitted or received an SBIR award. That's our target market at NSF. So if you have never submitted a SBIR proposal or received an award, you are the person that we really want to hear from. So most of our companies that get awards are going to fit that profile. They are small businesses, they are people with just one or two personnel, they are startups, and they have not received an award in the SBIR program previously. All right, so there are, I have quite a few slides, you're gonna get these slides. The one thing I would say to you, we just had a kind of a nightmare because you really have to register with SAM. We found out after our solicitation was released that NSF is now requiring that you have a SAM registration first. If you are thinking about submitting in December, go out now and register. Get your PEMS number, get your company started, register with SAM, because it is the only way that you're going to be able to submit a proposal at NSF. And you can go to our website. Of course, all the information in great detail is out on our website. Please go there. And finally, just one last plug. I've been asked to just mention that you might also, some of you in the audience might be interested in our I-Corps program. Please Google NSF I-Corps as well, and we'll get that program as well. That is all I have. Thank you very much. Pleasure meeting you, and good luck to you on your businesses.